If modern technology and training has been given to the likes of Borg, Labour, Newcomb, Sampras, Connors, who would now be your 1, 2, and 3?
Oh boy. Two horns of beer, one brought to go. Well, I think that's the great question, isn't it? Always, we always ask about these great questions of champions of yesteryear and how they will compare with champions of today in any sport. And I think the greatness of our sport is the fact that it's an individual sport. It's like running. It's like when Bannister broke the 4-minute mile. You know, when the first guy to run the sub 10-second 100 meters. And today it seems to be the norm. You know, whether it's whether you say Bolt hasn't run in the last 3-4 months. But if you see Asafa Powell, and you see, you know, Tyson Gay, Justin Gatlin, all these guys who break the 10-second mark quite comfortably. Or you see the drives that, you know, the guys are hitting on the golf course, you know. 300 yards is nothing anymore. Everybody's driving a short par four, you know, the regaling holds left and right. I mean, there's a whole slew of things that have happened in sport. But the thing that has happened in our sport is that it still remains an individual sport. And that the equipment has changed to such a great extent. When the great Rod Laver won his first professional Grand Slam in 1962, he won it with a wooden racket. He went on to not play the majors for another 7 years, till he won again in 1969. He won the Grand Slam again when it was open. So I think you're looking at great champions in different eras that can't be compared, but they all had one thing in common, and that was their greatness that would have appeared at any time. If Federer had played back in the day, when we played, I think he would still be the champion. If Borg had played back in the day, I think he would still be the champion. So I think it's hard to draw that, but we just have to leave it to the fact that all of them have something special that you can't quantify. And I'm not quite sure you can buy it at the supermarket. You really have to have it in you, and to some extent develop it. Like Ivan Lendl, you know. Ivan Lendl and John McEnroe are always the examples that I give. Ivan Lendl had less talent in his entire body than John McEnroe had in the little finger. What it took Ivan Lendl 1 week to accomplish, it took John McEnroe 30 minutes. But they were both number one. Because hard work always overcomes lack of talent. But a more abundance of talent is not going to overcome.
Okay, last two questions. I think it's